What is going on? It's Tyler here and welcome to yet another review. In this video I will review a replica of the Samsung Galaxy A5 called the HTC Galaxy A5, also known as the A5000. I ordered this on the website called kmall.com. As always, I will provide more info down below in the video description, so don't forget to check this out. So in this video I will not be able to cover all aspects of this phone as I will make it a little shorter. This will not be an in-depth review but a mini review, but if you have any questions please comment below and I will try to answer them if I can. So this phone comes with the MTK6582 chipset, 1GB RAM and 8GB ROM, Android KitKat and a 5-inch IPS HD screen and a very nice metal body. So we see here the front and we also see it comes with the Samsung logo here. We have the light and proximity sensor in the top, we have the earpiece. We also find here a 2-megapixel interpolated camera, but in fact this will only be 1.3 megapixel. We see here the nice frame here, and this one is made in full aluminium. We also see here on this side we find the volume rockers. You also notice the very thin bezels here, and below here we find the home button together with the menu and back button, and these have backlight. Here in the bottom we find the microphone together with the micro USB port and the 3.5 mm headphone jack. Let's turn it around and see here we find two trays. Actually it's dual SIM, so you can use two nano SIM cards, and this SIM tray here is also a micro SD card slot. Here we find the power button. In the top we find nothing. Actually there was a small sticker, I have removed this, and this sticker just said Qualcomm 4G, because on the original there's also a small sticker, but we know this is a clone, so in fact this is not a Qualcomm 4G. Also we find here in the top here a small fake noise cancelling microphone. This one does nothing here. So here on the back we find a 8 megapixel rear camera. And I believe actually it's interpolated to 13 megapixel. We find here the LED flash and we have here the back speaker. So this is a little bit special that we have the back speaker placed here and not here in the bottom of the phone. But actually I like this kind of design here, looks nice. We have here the Samsung logo. And we also see here some logos, I think it's similar to the CE logo. And we see some here on Chinese saying LTE, but this phone here is not LTE, it only works on the 3G network. And what you also notice is that the back cover here cannot be opened, there's no possibility to open this. And actually the back cover here is made of metal, I don't know if it's real aluminium, but some kind of metal that is here painted in white. And the white is I would call pearl white, it's not just the normal white. As I see it, it does shine a lot in the light here, you see. So it does really look nice. Okay, let me do a 360 degree of the phone. Okay. And let me also show you here the SIM trays. So let me open up. So here I'm using a nano SIM card, you can see it here. And in this one here you can use nano SIM card also, or you can use a TF card, micro SD card. And let me just compare the phone with some other phones here. So here you see the HTC M8, so in size it's very similar, but it's a little bit smaller actually. And here I have the Xiaomi Mi 4, but the Xiaomi Mi 4 is actually a little bit thicker. So the A5 here is very thin. Let me turn on the screen here, we see here the lock screen. You also see a nice animation here, we can go to the camera directly. We see the light here in the buttons. Let me unlock here. And There's also a code to activate or deactivate the Samsung logo. Actually, the Samsung logo was always activated when I got the phone, but you can deactivate it also, and I tried to deactivate it, and let me now try to activate it again with this code here. So star square 0075 square, selected logo new, it will say. Let's try. Let me try to turn off the phone and restart. Yeah, and we see the Samsung shutdown animation here. Let's see when it will boot. Yeah, we also see here the Samsung Galaxy A5 logo powered by Android. And here the Samsung animation and sound. Okay, and let me show you the screen here first. First I must say that the screen is HD IPS, but it's not OGS, and you see that pretty clearly when you hold the phone like this. Somehow it looks like the screen is deeper inside the housing, and if it was OGS it would be much more flat actually, and the viewing angle would also be much better. So no OGS, no one glass solution, only IPS and HD, but still I would say the screen is pretty good. Let us have a look here on the UI and the speed. Let me just scroll a little bit so you can see. So it's okay. It's not the fastest, but it's okay, because you must remember this phone is also really cheap. So of course you get a lower CPU inside. As told in the beginning, it's only the 6582. So it's only a quad core, but for normal use it's okay, I would say. Let's have a look inside the app drawer here, and let me scroll a little bit here. So you notice the speed is not bad. Could be better, but it's okay. Let us have a look here on the camera. So here we see the camera app. Let me just play something here, a phone. So you notice the autofocus is working. Let's try here. Okay, so the light is a little bit bright now here. And of course I will also provide some camera samples below in the video description. So if you want to see some high resolution camera samples, remember to check these out there. So you can see the front facing is not sharp at all. Actually, this picture got very blurry here, you see, but that's what you can expect from a 1.3 megapixel front facing camera. And what do we else have here? We have mode. So we have panorama, beauty face, HDR and so on. Some of these could of course be fake. Let's try HDR. Let's see here. No, there's not much difference, but because I think actually it's like normal pictures, just multi-angle. That's also just a normal picture. So some of these are just fake, I think. Okay, this one seems to work. Panorama. Smile also. Auto. Let's have a look inside the settings. There's a lot of different settings also for the video mode here, you see, the quality. Let's also test out the LED flash on the back, and you see it here. So this one is really bad and weak, you see, nearly doesn't light anything up here. So don't expect anything from this one here. It's just a cheap LED. So let me just demonstrate here the screen colors. Let's see here in the gallery, and let's see here some really nice pictures here. So you can see very vivid colors, and the screen is actually sharp when you have some really nice photos like these. And let us also have a look here on the reception. Right now I have enabled mobile data, so you see the H, I'm getting H speed here. We also see the network reception, but this indicator seems always to be in top. So I think maybe this one is not real. It's a fake indicator, but the battery indicator is real, of course. And we also see here the icon with an eye. And I think this maybe is for the eye scrolling, but I tried it and I couldn't get it to work with the built-in browser, so I guess this one is also just fake. Let's test out the multi-touch tester here. And you can see I already tried it actually, so it just says 2. There's no possibility to get more than 2 here. Try here with 3, 4, 5, no. So sadly, only 2 multi-point supported here. Let's have a look inside CPU identifier. So most of these informations are also fake. Saying Qualcomm, of course it's not Qualcomm. Saying Samsung, it also say 2 GB RAM. So this one is of course only 1 GB. But true is the display size. We also see here it says the MTK6582 4.4.4 KitKat. Let's check inside link to SD. Let's check the storage. So we see here internal 1 GB SD card here. I guess the SD card is the phone storage. We have the system and CAS. So totally we should actually have about 8 GB. We see here 5 GB plus the 1, the 6 GB, and the rest is for the ROM file and the system files. Let's try out a test call. Let's test the earpiece here.
Press 1. To change your personal options, press 2.
So that's the earpiece, and this is the proximity sensor. Okay. So the phone also support double tap to wake. Let me demonstrate it here. See, it wakes up. Let me try SC. And you can see this will start up the gallery actually. So these are the off-screen gestures. Let's check here inside the settings there. Let's first have a look on the quick toggles. So most of them are fake actually. We have SB and NFC, it says AirView, but all these do nothing, just fake options here. Let's see here in the settings, quick settings here, and we have here of course all the standard settings for SIM cards, Wi-Fi and so on. We have display, sound, wallpaper. So the only special we have here is motion and gesture here. Screen gesture, wake up, for example, double click, I showed that. You can slide to right, slide up and down, to one C, to one M, O and W and so on, to start up some apps. We have here shake to update, turn over to mute. We have smart screen, smart stay, smart rotation, smart pause, smart scroll, but these are also fake. There is no smart scroll, I tested this. Air browse, when we go inside here you can see these are not enabled and you can also not enable them. So the phone is not supporting any kind of air gestures. maybe a bug in the software. But let's see what we else have here. We have accounts, accessibility, language and setup. Let's have a look inside here. So most are supported here. You find developer options, about, devices. Let's see here. We see here the model number, Android version, build number and so on. Let's check here the Android. Android KitKat, of course. So this is real KitKat. So that's it for the settings. Most of the other settings here are just stock settings for display and sound and wallpaper and so on. We can have a short look here inside sound, display. Lock screen. And of course you can also switch here to tab view instead. Galaxy apps here. So I think this is maybe the Samsung app store. Yeah, seems to be real from Galaxy apps for Galaxy. Let me show you here the YouTube app. So you can see the YouTube app is also working here. This is my playlist here with phone reviews. Let's see here. So now to some pros and cons about this phone here. So first the pros. The biggest pro about it is the phone design and the low price, because this phone is really thin and actually kind of beautiful. It also comes with real KitKat 4.4.4. It has a HD 720p display and the colors and sharpness is actually okay. The only downside is that it's not OGS one glass solution, so the screen is not that good from angles, the viewing angles are not the best. The battery does pretty well, and it is possible to go through one day with the battery if you don't use mobile data too much and don't do heavy games and so on. It supports real OTA. Actually, I got one update while I tested the phone, and the back speaker is pretty loud and the quality is okay. So two of the cons are that the network reception indicator is fake. This one will always show full signal actually, so you can't actually see if it is bad or good. And as told, there's no OGS screen, so the viewing angles are not the best. It also only support 2-point multi-touch, and that's really bad. 5 or 10 would have been much better. And another thing is that it can get a little bit hot sometimes, and for some reason there are settings for air gestures, but the air browser doesn't really work. And also regarding the GPS, I was not able to get any fix or lock, so I don't think that the GPS is working in this phone. What I also noticed was that inside the camera settings there are some few fake settings that don't have any feature or function. And the last thing is that the phone also doesn't support USB on the go. I tried it on the phone, but the USB on the go was not found when I tried it, so I guess it isn't supported. So the final words are that the phone is really nice to look at. It has a really stunning and amazing design. It's made of aluminium here in the side on the, and the back, and overall it feels really really nice in the hand. The build quality is nice and solid, but inside the software there is a lot of fake options and fake apps, because we are talking about a clone here, and the quality inside the phone is not the best and not the fastest. But for the price, I would say you get a okay basic phone here. And if you just want to use it for phone calls, SMS and a little bit internet and surfing, then this one here would be okay. But if you are a power user, you and you use a lot of apps, play heavy games, download a lot, then I would not recommend this. But as always, I do not really recommend to buy clones for anything else than fun, or if you can't afford to buy the real one, because of course the original Samsung Galaxy A5 is much much better than this replica here. A clone is only the last solution if you can't get the real one, or if you just want a phone for fun or testing. So that's it for now. Stay tuned on my channel for more videos. If you have any questions or special requests, please comment below. Give a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. See ya.